Jesus isn't looking for, he's not looking for like a little, he's looking for a whole big life.
He's looking for us to give him a whole life.
He's looking to give us everything. Everything.
Yeah.
Love Jesus.
Jesus loves you. You always hand out stuff because this is how you know that you're loved by Jesus, right? You give him something. Here's a prayer cloth. You get a prayer cloth here. It's a red one. God bless you. Jesus loves you. He came that we could live. He came that we could have life more abundantly. Who needs healing today? Who needs healing today?
Well, Jesus, you know, he's sitting on the throne. He's waiting for somebody to go and do a good work for him. He's waiting. He says, where are my children? Have they given all up because of my love? Will they come after me with their whole heart, mind, and soul? Will they do it? He's asking a question. Will you come and know Jesus today? Will you come and know his love that never fails? Will you come and know the true way, the true master of your heart, the one who intricately made you in the palm of his hands? He placed you in your mother's womb, blew life inside of you because of his love for you. You're made in his image, but the very hairs on your head are all numbered. He even knows every hair on your head. And if one hair will fall, he counts it. Who does that? He knows the thoughts towards you. That's a peace not of evil to give you an expected end. He came to love you back to life. Let me just tell you a story. I'm going to tell you a story. I was verbally abused all my life. Some of y'all need to hear this testimony today. I was verbally abused, and I was told that I wouldn't be anything, and that's a lie. It's a lie. Because I am somebody, and so are you. So, you know, I didn't do good in my life because those words were seeds, and they grew. And it grew up a wrong garden. So don't listen to words that are bad. If you listen to words that are bad, say, I rebuke that in the name of Jesus when somebody tells you something bad. Because we don't accept it. We only accept good things. Like you're loved and you're beautiful because you are. You may not think so. You know, I didn't think I was. All of those years. All of those broken years. Thinking that I was nothing when I was everything. What am I? But what happened? I met Jesus on the road to go to hell. Yeah, Jesus met me. I had a one-way ticket to hell, and some of you all have a one-way ticket too. It's time to get Jesus today. If I would have died without getting Jesus, I would be burning today. But no, Jesus came for me. Thank you, Jesus. So I'm going to stand on the street corner and tell you what he did to a broken mess like me. I was addicted. I was drinking every day. You know, I was thinking that I was always one drink away from solving my own life's problems. Oh, if I just had one more drink, man, I got this life. You couldn't talk to me. You can just get out of here. That was my life. You couldn't tell me anything, man. I knew it all.
I got this.
You know what? I didn't know anything. I didn't know anything. I was selfish. It was all about me, myself, and I. And what can I have? And what can I get? Can I take all I can? And can all I take? Yeah, and then I met Jesus. And everything changed around. Everything changed. Like, he took a broken, shattered mess, and he made it his masterpiece in the palm of his hand. This is what he does. He takes the ones that are addicted and have stage 2 leukemia cancer, and he takes it out of them and restores them, and then he puts a little cross on their shoulder so that Jesus can tell you that he loves you. Because he says, if you don't go, how will they know? How will they know? Oh, thank you, sir. Appreciate it. How will they know if you don't go? You're dearly loved. Nothing can separate you from the love of your Father. I'm going to tell you that right now. Don't listen to anybody else. Nothing can separate you from his love. Some of you all need a new change today. Come and get a new change. Come get transformed in his hands. You know, I couldn't heal myself. I couldn't have stopped drinking on my own. No! It was only by Jesus. It was only by his stripes that I could actually talk to you today in a clear mind. You know that Jesus says that if you come to me and ask me, I will give it to you. He'll never turn you away. He'll never say no to you. That's why I love him. Because he'll never say no to you. He'll always love you. He'll never say no. You know, people can say no to you. People aren't going to love you like Jesus loves you. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Jesus doesn't change. Jesus says, I love you and I'm proud of you. You may not believe it, but you have loved. You may not feel it now, but it doesn't matter if you feel it. It doesn't matter if you see it. God is for you and God loves you. He loves you so much that he was his love when he hung there for you? How much was his love when he endured the pain, despised the shame? All because of his love for you. You alone are worthy of Jesus.
You may not think it. You may not feel it. It doesn't matter if you feel it, or if you think it, or if you know it. Because when you get Jesus, he's going to reveal himself to you. Hey, when you get Jesus, he's going to reveal himself to you. He's going to reveal yourself to you.
I love you.
He's going to reveal himself to you.
He's going to reveal himself to you by telling you I love you. I love you. I'm in love with you. I've been knocking on your door all of these years. I've been saving you from yourself all of these years. So you will come into my courts. Come into my gates with praise. Will you come into my kingdom for everything I and my arms are wide open, and I want to give you everything, everything that I am. You are in this world, and greater works are you to do. Now that I have gone and set at the right hand of the throne of God, interceding for you, I need you. I am missing a part of me when you are away from my heart, when you are away from my mind. I'm missing out on the greatest thing that I ever you? It's right here now. It's here now. God's a now God. God's not a yesterday God. He's a here now. He is watching in charge, and he's always on time. You may think he's late. He's not late. He's not going by your time. He's going by God's time. God's time is always good. He's always faithful and true. He's the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end, and everything in between. And he knows your little life. And he knows who left you. And he knows who molested you. And he knows everything. And he says, when are you going to call on my name? When are you going to lay it all down? When are you going to throw away your sin and your shame?
A chance for healing.